What's going on, guys? It's me, Fluffy Noodles, and today I'm doing a mod review on the Portal Gun mod. It's basically based on Portal, the game Portal, you know, that beautiful game where you have those guns that make portals. Yep, yep. It's based on that. Yep, yep, yep. Okay, but holy crap, okay. Alright, today I'll be doing that. Yeah, so to craft these portal guns, these beautiful portal guns, these nice looking portal guns, yeah, you craft them by doing this inside right here. So what you'll need is obsidian, a diamond, iron ingots, and a miniature black hole. And there's many different types of portal guns. There are five different types of portal guns. There's the Atlas portal gun, Peabody portal gun, bacon gun, and potato gun. You can all craft them by just using the regular portal gun and putting them with light blue dye to make this, the dandelion yellow to make Peabody's gun, and raw pork to make bacon gun, potato for OS. I don't even know how to get that actually, but you know, whatever. But that makes a potato gun. That's pretty neat. And what these do are, okay, but what you do is you right click to send out one portal, and then you left click to send out another portal. Yeah, and then it has to be a 2-block surface, so it has to be like 2 blocks high or 2 blocks long or whatever to work, and you just walk through and bam, you're out of the portal. And you can place them as far as apart as possible or whatever, I don't know how to say it, but it doesn't really matter how far you put it apart, unless it's like all of the way across the world. Yeah, I think that's how it works, like whatever. But there's a really cool thing you can do with these. It's like a trick that can make you go extremely high and possibly kill you, but you know, who cares. Also, to retrieve these portals, you may be wondering, what do you do? Oh my god, how do you retrieve these portals? You press R. Magic. Okay, so this is the thing I was talking about. You put two portals right next to each other, and you go in, and then you just walk into one portal, and it keeps sending you up really, really high up. It never stops, and it just keeps making you go extremely high up, and you can, yeah, work it. Mm-hmm. Look at those abs. Okay, yeah, so you just keep standing here until it, like, brings you to, like, a point where you die. I don't know. I don't think that's a thing in Minecraft, but, you know, who cares. So, yeah, I need to get out of this now. Press R, and, so, yeah, another cool, very, very cool thing you can do with these is do nothing. Ha ha ha. No, I'm joking. Another cool thing you can do with these is go down here. You can press G and then, oh wait, no, on a piece of dirt. Yeah. Okay, you press G. It lifts up a block out of the ground, any block. And then with that block, you can right click and left click to let go of the block. And another cool thing you can do is just spin around really fast. And then while you're spinning around, you can press left or right click and it lets go of the block, and you can throw the block extremely far. Oh, that wasn't very good. Oh, that wasn't a good example, but you know. Wait, hold on a second. Yeah, there we go. That's a farther block. Yep, that's a lot farther. See, wait, oh yeah. Yeah, I don't think those portals are gonna reach it. Oh, whatever. I'm gonna put this portal gun back. And yeah, you guys might be wondering, how do you craft those black holes, Fluffy? I have to cover up my identity, Fluffy Noodles. Yeah. How do you craft it, Fluffy Noodles? You just take Ender Pearl Dust and a Nether Star, which is not very cheap. It's actually quite expensive. But yeah, to make the Ender Pearl Dust, you just take an Ender Pearl, you put it in a furnace, you cook the Ender Pearl or smelt it, and then it turns into Ender Pearl Dust. So that's actually pretty simple to make. And yeah, I'll be moving on to the portal spawner. So these portal spawners, they're pretty neat. They spawn portals. They do exactly what their name says, or whatever. They spawn portals. So yeah, this is supposed to be in here. Yeah, just forget that ever happened. But yeah, you put to craft it, you put 2 iron ingots here, diamond and stuff, and then iron ingots here, and then another miniature black hole, which is extremely expensive. And then the portal spawner, I'll show you. Well, it gives you two portal spawners, and I'll show you what the portal spawner does. You place it on to here, and then you can right click it, and then it gives you options. This is, do portals close when redstone power is cut? You can either put no or yes. I'm gonna put yes for here, and you can also choose the color for what it is. I'm gonna choose red, I guess, and over here I'm gonna choose blue, and I'm gonna set it to no. So if I bring the redstone torch over here and I press, oh, and I activate it, and then once I cut the redstone torch off, the portal disappears. But then if I come over here, then the portal opens and it stays open, it doesn't close. So yeah, those are, oh, that's the pretty neat thing about this. If I punch it, then this wall breaks. Rip wall. Yep. Okay, but that's basically what the portal spawner does. It is pretty neat, I guess, but I don't think it's worth it for all this material with two portal spawners, which is not very good, I think. It's kind of better to just make the portal gun. So yeah, that's the portal spawners. So moving on to the long fall boots. These will help you not die when you jump from high places, like the portal gun. If you fall from like a high mountain or whatever when you're using it, then this is basically what happens. Well, this is what helps you not die. It's basically feather falling like 100,000, so it will not let you die. And the iron ingot, well, to craft it, it's 3 iron ingots on both sides, obsidian and 2 diamond. And that creates 1 long fall boot, so you have to do this twice to create 2 long fall boots, and then you just put those 2 long fall boots together and it makes long fall boots. No, no, man, those are long fall boot. Oops. Okay, pretend like that never happened. Yeah. Technical difficulties, haha. Okay, wait, hold on a second. Okay, so yeah, the long fall boots, I'll show you an example of them right now. I'll go into game mode 0 and I'll put these on, jump off a cliff, and no damage token. So yeah, let me go back to game mode 1 and I'll come back up here. I'm gonna put these back where it's supposed to be. Hold on a second, let me take these off. Okay, my Yeezy boots, no, my Yeezy Boost 9000s, yeah, they're no longer there. So yeah, they're actually pretty useful. I definitely think this is worth it so you don't die. It's very good, actually. So if you're like jumping down a mountain or something, you definitely won't die. Or if you use the portal gun accidentally and then you like walk into the portal and then it's on a really high place or whatever, and yeah, you won't die because of that. So moving on to the turrets, these are actually some of my favorite things inside of this mod. To craft a turret, you just use 1 redstone, 5 iron ingots, and 2 obsidian. So that creates a sentry turret. There's also a oracle turret, I think that's how you pronounce it, and it says I'm different. I'm pretty sure you can craft this, but if you just keep crafting like this recipe, you have a chance of getting the oracle turret, which is kind of weird, I don't know. But you can also get a defective turret by smelting a sentry turret, and that creates a defective turret, which is defective. So yeah, I don't even know why someone would do that. So the only way to test this out is if I take mobs. Hold on a second, let me get a mob. Okay, I'm gonna get some skeletons, I guess. I'm gonna come over here. Hold on a second. Yep, okay, I'm gonna... Well, that's an example. These cows are getting killed by these turrets, but you can also do this. Point these turrets over here. That one's facing backwards. Okay, that's defective. Okay, you can already see what they're doing. They're shooting everywhere in front of them. So if I place a skeleton down here, then... Oh, wait, never mind. I have it in peaceful. Oopsies, okay. So if I drop the skeleton down, then you can see these turrets are spraying them down with bullets. And yeah, the turrets don't have much health though. As you can see, if I run into them, they instantly die, and if I punch them, they die. So it dies really easily, which is kind of bad because you can use these as defense. But the turrets also can kill you if you walk in front of them in survival, then they do shoot you and you can die and stuff. So yeah, I'm gonna place this back here. The defective turret is just defective. It does not work. It's burnt and it's very bad. But you get this by smelting it. I think I've already said that, but you know. So yeah, I'm gonna move on to the other section now. Moving on to the cubes, or so you call it, companion cubes in Portal. You craft a weighted storage cube, which can be turned into a weighted companion cube. So you craft the weighted storage cube by using stone and iron ingots into, well, in a, you put this in a crafting table, and it crafts into a weighted storage cube. You can get a weighted companion cube by taking the storage cube, you place it down, and you give it a poppy, and it turns into a weighted companion cube. The weighted storage cube is actually kind of useless. It doesn't do anything except for move around if you push it. But yeah, but the weighted companion cube, it helps a lot. If you put it inside of your inventory, it regens your health every 5 seconds. It gives you some health back every 5 seconds, so it heals you basically. And yeah, that's kind of useful. That's all these cubes are do, kind of. Yeah, this is basically all they do. This is useless, this is useful. That's the only thing that matters. So yeah, so moving on to the music discs. These are actually just music discs actually, so you know. Yeah, so to start off with, to create a music disc, the basic music disc, it's you just use a weighted companion cube, and then you smelt it in the furnace, and it turns into a still alive music disc. You use this music disc, you smelt it again to create a radio loop, and you use this radio loop, and then you put iron ingots around it like so, and then it creates a radio. The radio is a thing you can place down, and then you right click it to turn it on, then you right click again to turn it off. I'm not gonna play any music right now because I might get copyrighted, so yeah. But you take the radio loop and you make a radio, and then you take two still alive discs to make a Want You Gone. Now you don't need to smelt these, you just take these two and you put it in a crafting table or your like inventory up there, and you craft it, and it creates a Want You Gone music disc. And yeah, this is actually pretty simple to make and stuff. Actually no, that's not simple at all. None of this is simple in any way. And I don't get how you smelt a weighted companion cube into a disc. Oh, but you know, moving on to the faith plate, this is a very, very neat thing that is actually pretty cool. If you want to make this, you craft it with two obsidian glass, one redstone, and three iron ingots, like so. And then the aerial faith plate is pretty good, and it's pretty cool and stuff. So to use it, you place one, like, let me clear an area first. Okay, so you place it on the ground, and you walk on it, and it plunges, like, well, it makes you go straight up. Well, not straight up, like, makes you fly. And then you can adjust how powerful it is by moving these and moving these. This is the vertical power, this is the horizontal power, and you can adjust if it needs redstone or not. And when you walk on it, it can launch you extremely far or not as far. So yeah, this is actually a pretty cool thing. You can use it for adventure maps or something, or just getting around your house in survival if you want to play that, or you can use this on a server or something. That's pretty neat. So I'll just break it right now. Let me grab it. Okay, so I'll move up here. Hold on a second. Okay, so that's the wrong chest. Oopsies. Okay, oops, that's the wrong chest. Okay, so I'll just put this back. And moving on to the high pellet launcher and high energy pellet catcher. So you craft the high energy pellet launcher with gold, redstone, and iron ingots, and you craft the high energy pellet catcher with obsidian, iron ingots, gold, and redstone. And how these work is like over here. I got a whole setup already. You just take a redstone torch, you place it right next to the launcher, and you place it right next to here. It launches an energy ball, and it keeps bouncing back and forth. And then the catcher is over here, which is trying to accept the ball, but there's something in the middle, which is a piece of wood. And then the ball will keep going back and forth between the piece of wood until the ball has hit the block enough times, and then the ball explodes. As you can see right there, it turns into mist, and then it also leaves a mark on the block that it is hitting. And the pellet, well, the pellet launcher, it can also do damage to you. As you can see, I'm in creative, but you can still hear the hit damage, and it does knock back. So this can be used in an adventure map or something. And once I break this block, the catcher will accept the ball, and then it activates all the redstone and stuff. And then, yeah, it activates all the redstone. And moving on to these things, you might be wondering, what are those? So yeah, I'll be over here and I'll be showing you guys what those are. So coming over here, this is the weighted companion cube vent and weighted storage cube vent. So yeah, to craft the weighted companion cube vent, you just use a weighted companion cube and all this stuff like so, and you craft it together in a crafting table, and it creates this. And then the weighted storage cube, you do what's basically the same exact crafting recipe, except you use a weighted storage cube instead of a weighted companion cube. So yeah, and also you can craft a electronic intelligence indicator by using iron, redstone, and glass. And if you come over here, this is the weighted storage cube vent, and this is the weighted companion cube vent. All right, let me knock these back in place. Oopsies, I think I did something. And this is the intelligence indicator thingamadoobob, the electronic intelligence indicator. Yeah, it just gives a check mark, so it can be for like checkpoints and stuff. It gives a check mark every single time it's activated by redstone. And these things, they drop a companion cube down. Well, it drops a this one, which is the companion cube vent. It drops a companion cube down every time it has redstone is activated. And then this is the storage cube thing. I forgot what it's called already, but it drops down a companion cube every single time redstone is activated. And then it will suck back the companion cube once redstone is cut off. So like, say so if I turn this off, wait, hold on a second. Okay. So say so if I turn, okay, yeah, so if I turn, okay, I don't know how to, wait, hold on a second. Yep, there we go. That's a simpler way. Okay, so if I turn it off, then this shows back to an X, and this stuff is supposed to suck it back up. Wait, hold on a second. I have to move these back. Yep, I think I kind of screwed this up because I moved it. But it's supposed to suck it back up. You can use this in a server or something. I'm pretty sure this is meant for like a big group of people, probably servers and stuff. So yeah, that is pretty cool actually. It drops down one of these and you can pick it up. And then coming over here, this is the last thing out of this whole entire mod, I guess. It's called a portal gun pedestal. You need obsidian, iron ingots, and redstone. And I already have a... Okay, this is pretty annoying now. Okay, I'm gonna turn it to peaceful, but this is basically what it is. It is a pedestal that you put your portal gun on. And if you activate it, then the portal gun pedestal starts spinning, and it starts shooting portals down. Like, you see, there's a portal there, and it just spins again. It deactivates that portal, and shoots out another portal over there, and it would just keep doing that for a long time. And then, yeah, this is basically the whole entire mod. I guess I'll wrap it up for you guys. But I have one last really cool thing that some of you guys might not know. If you've ever played this mod, then you probably know this already. But R, accept that portal back, and if I shoot a portal to the moon and wait for it to light up, hold on a second, yep, it's lit up, and then I right click over here, you guys will see the madness. It starts sucking up everything. It's literally a black hole. If you look down on it, it's literally a picture of the earth. At least this is actually from the moon. It just sucks down everything. If you put stuff down nearby, then it should suck it up. Hold on a second. Wait, let me retrieve this. Both of these, let me shoot that over there again and wait for it. It's gonna suck everything up. Let me put it in a village, actually. This would probably work better if I put in this temple. Yeah, hold on a second. Let me break this. Yeah, so, yeah. Bye, people. Wait, hold on a second. Yep. Bye. If I shoot it down, then this whole temple's going bye-bye. Bye. Yeah, it literally is going bye-bye. And if you can shoot it again, and it sucks down every single block, and it can kill you too if you walk into it, and it can kill you, and it also sucks you up. But you can, oh, I'm in creative, so it won't really kill me right now, but it can kill you if you're in survival, and it can suck you to the moon, and it literally just kills you. And this is a pretty cool thing that I never knew about. It can also suck up water. Oh wait, never mind. It can't. Rip. Oh, I'm pretty sure it can suck up these squid. I just want to suck up these squid. Please. Get sucked up. Okay, I'm gonna try sucking up these squid. Hold on a second, guys. Be patient with me. Okay. Gosh darn. Whatever. Yeah. I guess I'll see you guys next time. I might do some more Jettercraft in my next video. And, yeah. Water can break portals. That's something I just found out. So, yeah, I'll see you guys next time. And, yeah, I'll die or whatever. Yeah. Yeah, hold on a second. Wanna end it like this? Okay.
Bye. Wait. Bye, people. Bye. 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 Constipation. Yeah.